This is the day the Lord hath made, and we are rejoicing and we are glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Almighty God, we thank you for this day. Oh God, we look unto you today because you are the author and the finisher of our faith. We thank you that no weapon that is formed against us today will prosper. And we thank you that every tongue that rises up against us today in judgment will be condemned. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for leading us, Lord Jesus, in the paths of righteousness for your name's sake. We thank you for Joy Gospel Radio FM. We thank you for the host, Sister Angela. We thank you for each and every person that is assisting to carry this work around the globe. And we say yes to your will and to your way. In Jesus' name, amen. Today, we want to talk about still accountable. You are still accountable. And we want to use two scriptures, 2 Timothy, the third chapter, verses 1 to 5. 2 Timothy, the third chapter, verses 1 to 5. And Ezekiel, the third chapter, verse 16 to 21. Still accountable. In 2 Timothy, the Lord informed us that in the last days began at the birth of Jesus Christ. We are in the last days. No, the last days did not start last year. The last days did not start 2 years ago. It began, amen, with the birth of Christ. And it will culminate when Jesus Christ returned here and set up his kingdom. We are in the last days. So in the last days, perilous times shall come. Good God Almighty. Men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy. The last days began at the birth of Christ, and today it has intensified even the more. Good God Almighty. Tell somebody you're still accountable. He said, people shall be without natural affection. Look at what is going on in the world, the intensity of it. Without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, slanderers. Good God Almighty. Incontinent. Fierce. Despisers of those that are good. Is anybody out there experiencing these things? Or you're seeing these things? And if you're experiencing or seeing these things, you know without a shadow of a doubt, we are in the last days. Look at verse 4. Traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. Church people. Yes, they will go to church on their particular days, but a lot of people, they love pleasure more than how they love God. And you have to be very, very careful, good God Almighty, of identifying yourself with that group if you love pleasures more than how you love God. Look at the fifth verse. Having a form of godliness. Good God Almighty. Just a form. The outward show, they will demonstrate a form. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. And that last part of that verse, turn away, is very crucial in this message today, because we have to be very, very careful. We are not turning away from being accountable to God. We turn away from those false teachings. We turn away from those lifestyles. But tell somebody, we are still accountable. Let's go to Ezekiel, the third chapter. You can't turn your back and say, well, I don't want to bother with people that are not godly. No, 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 no. You can turn your back because you see people are lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. Yes, you turn away from that lifestyle. You turn away from the teaching, but you are still accountable. Parents, in spite of how disobedient your children are, what I'm sharing with you this morning, you are still accountable to do something about it. You cannot make them, but you're accountable. Listen to this. Ezekiel, the third chapter, verse 16. It came to pass at the end of 7 days that the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, and God is speaking to somebody today. He says, son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. Good God Almighty, saints of God, don't turn away. Ezekiel was placed in a position to warn the people of God. You are placed in a position in these last days to warn God's people, to warn the world of their behavior, to warn your children, to warn those that God has placed under your care. You are still accountable to God in spite of what you are seeing in these last days. God has commissioned you to warn the people. Tell somebody you are still accountable. I don't care how disobedient they are. You are the voice of the living God. I don't care how many traitors are around you. You are the voice of the living God. I don't care how many are loving pleasures more than how they're loving God. You are still accountable to God to warn them of their errors. Look at verse 17. Verse 18. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning. You know what God is saying to some folks? They are going to die. But God is saying, you are responsible, you are accountable to give them that warning. Good God Almighty. How many of you know in your spirit that road, yes, that road that a child is going, the end of that road is death? Yes, they believe that they know more than you. They believe that they're smarter than you. But you are still accountable to warn them, because you know that on that road, they are facing death. Yes, tell them to put down that bottle of liquor. Yes, they're legalizing marijuana in a lot of places, Oh, God, thank you. Amen. And some people are enjoying that and they're getting high. They're out of their mind. Good God Almighty. Not only marijuana, but those cigarettes. Those cigarettes that they're smoking, those alcohol that they're drinking, and they're still saying that they're children of God, that fornication life that they're living in, and they're still saying that they're children of God. I'm saying to you, my brothers and my sisters, give them the warning. The Bible said, come out from amongst them and be separate, said the Lord. Give them a warning. Good God. When I say to the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, not speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way, good God Almighty, to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Good God Almighty. God has entrusted you so much that if you refuse to warn the people, God is going to hold you responsible. God is going to say to you, you are to be blamed. And yes, you might be saying, Dr. Ambrose, that's their life. Yes, I know that. But you are accountable to God. How can they hear without a preacher? How can they believe in whom I am, in whom they have not heard? Good God, you are sent to these people to bring deliverance to them. Yes, I understand. And I know that they have been hearing and hearing and hearing down through the years. But God is saying to you today, don't close your mouth. Good God Almighty. Don't be quiet. And some of you have to speak out to the politicians. Don't be quiet. Let them know what they're doing is against God's will. And if they continue to do what they want to do, then the blood is not on your hand. Those disobedient, hard-headed children, you may not can make them do what you want them to do, but at least you can tell them that what they're doing is wrong. You have to save yourself because you are a child of God that's carrying a message in these last days. Look at verse 19. Yet, if thou warn the wicked, and he turn from his wickedness, good God, and he turn not, if you warn him, and he turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, good God, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul. You are at peace with God because you told the wicked person that he was going down the wrong road. You don't want to get caught with a message in your heart that you were supposed to deliver to somebody and that person died without receiving that message from you. You don't want to be guilty of that. How many times the Lord told you to tell somebody something and you reserve that message? You hold it back. And then the Lord convicts you. You should have said something. You did not say it, but somebody came after you and said exactly what you were supposed to say. That was training ground. Thank God that person did not die. But if that person died without you delivering a message, you will not be at peace in your spirit. God is saying to somebody today, yes, I know that you are frustrated, and I know that you are like Jeremiah saying, I will not preach again. I'm not going to say anything to that person or to that family anymore, but there's a fire on the inside of you, amen, that you have to deliver a message, preach the word to them, be instant in season and out of season. It may not be convenient for you. It may not be the right time, but preach it to them anyhow. Yes, your neighbor. That neighbor that believe that they're doing right. That neighbor that believe, amen, by persecuting the church, they're doing right. Yes, that person. That person that is slandering the church. That person that is talking about the people of God. You let them know that the Bible said, God said, they better don't touch his anointed and do his prophet no harm. They're slandering the church. And they're giving you all types of reasons why they are not going to church. They're calling church people phonies. They're saying all types of things about the church people. But I want you to know that some people that attend church, they attend church for that reason, is to bring a bad light on God's people. Everybody that go to church are not representing God. They have a form of godliness, but they're not submitting to the power of God. And these people are creating, amen, something bad for something else, for somebody else. They are stumbling block to other people. Good God Almighty. You have to let them know that everybody that go to church are not representing God. Be very careful how you slander God's people. And be very careful of who you're calling the children of God. Because many people have a form, but they're not submitting to the power of God. Stop that neighbor from slandering the church. Because what people call the church is not really the church. Some people are in the building, but they're not a part of the church. Good God Almighty. You let them know that they can be a part of God's church by surrendering their lives to God. It is not the denomination that they're supporting. It is not the church building where they're going, but they are part of God's church when they surrender their life, amen, to Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Tell them, let them know. You are accountable. I'm hearing in my spirit right now that God is raising up some people to have some Bible studies with some families. I need to repeat that because I'm hearing that strongly in my spirit, that God has called some of you to have Bible studies with some families. Yes, I know you have Bible study at your local church, but that is not enough because some people are not coming to the local church. They're on the sidelines and they're criticizing the local churches. But you are accountable to take the gospel to them. Sit down with them. Open up the word of God with them. Let them have an understanding of who Jesus is. Let them know it is only one God. Let that Buddhist and that Hindu and those Muslims know that Jesus is God. Open up the scriptures to them. Good God Almighty. They need to understand who Jesus is. They need to understand his purpose here on this earth. The reason why you're here on this earth carrying the gospel to the lost is because Jesus Christ is working in you to reach those that are lost, to give them the opportunity to surrender their life to the living God. Well, yes, I know that going to church every Sunday and every Saturday and every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays and Fridays, I know that all that is good. We will clap our hands, we will sing our songs, we will preach the word, we will hear the word preached. All that is good, amen. It is good fellowship, amen. But Jesus Christ is more, amen, he's more concerned about the soul of the lost and dying people. And they're dying every day. And they're dying every day, many of them, with lack of knowledge of who Jesus Christ is. Tell somebody that you are accountable. You are accountable to warn the wicked person. You're accountable to let them know that the way they're going out, amen, is the way of death. You have the word of God, not only on the pages, but the word of God is in your heart. You are accountable to warn the wicked from his wicked ways. If you don't do it, the blood will be on your hands. Good God Almighty. Look at verse 20. Again, when a righteous man doeth turn from his righteousness. Wow. You call it apostasy. They used to believe in God. They used to believe the teachings of God. Now they have turned from their righteousness. They're embracing something that is contrary to what they used to believe. Good God Almighty. When they turn from their righteousness and commit iniquity, and I, God said, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die because thou hast not given him warning. He shall die in his sin and his righteousness, which he had done, shall not be remembered. But his blood will I require at thine hand. I want to say something here, because a lot of times we as born again believers, I believe sometimes we polish things too much. You know the reason why that person is suffering like that. You know the reason why those stumbling blocks are in that person's way is because they have turned from God. Let them know the truth. Let them know the reason why these stumbling blocks are in your path is because you have turned away from righteousness. Stop, polish up these people and tell them the truth. Let them know if you return to God, good God Almighty, the favor that God promised you will be on your life. The Bible says, if God said, if he pronounced blessing upon any person, upon any nation, he said, if they turn from doing good and do evil, then he will change from the blessing. He will hold back the blessings. And some people that are in your circle, the stumbling blocks are in their way because they have turned away from God. Yes, I know God did promise them, but God has will to change. God has will to change concerning this matter. And I'm saying to some of you today, amen, warn the people. You are accountable to warn them. Tell them to turn away from their sins. Turn away from their iniquities. good God Almighty, and come back, amen, to righteousness. Yes, let them know that God has appointed them to sing. God has appointed them to give him praise and to preach his word. And now they're living in a backslidden position. Let them know those stumbling blocks are because of what they're doing right now. Stop, polish them and give them the truth. Look at verse 21. Nevertheless, if thou warn the righteous man that a righteous sin not, and he doeth not sin, he shall surely live, because he is warned. Also, thou hast delivered thy soul. You can live in peace. That person that you're counseling, and they're out there living a lifestyle that is ungodly, and they're still professing that they're righteous, you let them know. No, don't polish it up. Don't tell them that after a while, don't give them that polished message. After a while, it is going to be, no. You let them know. The Bible said, God said, come out from amongst them. Yes, these are the last days. And people are heady, they're high-minded, they're traitors. They're enjoying the pleasures. They're loving pleasures more than how they love God. And some people are falling prey to that because they're serving God for what they can get from God. But God wants people to serve him in spirit and in truth. God wants people to accept him as Lord over their lives. And when he's Lord over your lives, he's directing your path. Your answer is yes to his will, amen, and his way. You have denied yourself and you have taken up your cross and you're following the living God. He will give you what you should desire. He will place those desires in your heart. Yes, he will bless you. Yes, he will protect you. He will clothe you and he will feed you. But you must align your will with God's will. And when you pray according to his will. Not my will, Lord, but let your will be done. Tell them that when they have erred away from righteousness, let them know it is not godly. And don't polish them by listening to the excuses why they're not serving God anymore. Let them know it is a trick of the enemy. And when you do that, you will fulfill your accountability to the living God. And you can sleep in peace. You can rest in peace, knowing that you have delivered the message to the people that God has assigned you to do. Don't neglect what God has called you to do. You are still accountable. Lord, we thank you for blessing us. We thank you for keeping us. We ask that you give, oh God, every person under the sound of my voice, the strength that is needed, oh God, to carry out your work here on this earth. We will forever stand in that gap and represent you. We are your witnesses, good God Almighty. And we are empowered with the Holy Spirit, oh God, to do what you have called us to do. Continue to use us for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.